Welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Thomas Sandgaard. He is the CEO of Zynex. And Thomas, it's great to see you. How are you?
Yeah, good morning, Steve. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well, thank you. Excited to learn a bit more about the company and what you're up to. Tell me a little bit about Zynex.
Yes, Zynex is a medical device company, and we make devices for two sectors. Pain management, we also make devices for hospital monitoring. The company is 28 years old. I founded it in a one bedroom 28 years ago. And this year we'll see it 200 million in revenue. Just 7-8 years ago, we only had 11 million in revenue. So we've been growing fast, and we continue to grow at a double-digit percentage. And we pay very close attention to always being profitable and having a positive cash flow along the way. We've been very successful in doing so much that we've been able to buy back stock more than $80 million here over the past few years and invest tens of millions of dollars in our hospital monitoring division so far.
Yeah, let's talk about those two divisions. Let's begin with hospital monitoring. Tell me a little bit about that particular division and really the successes that you're seeing.
Yeah, in hospital monitoring, we have four game-changing products on the way. There's no revenue in that division yet, even though one of them in particular is very close, so that we can launch it here. We expect to file the application with the FDA here later this year in the fourth quarter, and hopefully get clearance in the beginning. It's a product that I call it's a much better mousetrap in the biggest medical device market in the world, which is pulse oximetry. We have a product there that will be trying to gain as much market share as possible. Not only are we able to more accurately detect oxygen levels in the blood the same way it's done today with typically with a finger clip, and we'll also be able to accurately detect carbon monoxide levels, reduced hemoglobin and methemoglobin. We'll be able to detect that very accurately. And I think these days it resonates a lot with people that we are able to accurately measure oxygen levels when someone has a dark skin pigmentation. That's a significant flaw with devices that are on the market today. Other than that, we have three other products on the way: a non-invasive blood volume monitor, early detection of sepsis, and also a monitoring device that can detect total hemoglobin levels, so you don't need to take that blood sample and wait a long time to actually get the results. You get that instantly without taking any blood. So those are the products that are on the way in the monitoring division.
And you look at the other side, and that's the pain side of things, and this affects millions upon millions of people around the world suffering with pain, and you've come up with some pretty interesting products in order to help with that.
Yeah, I'm proud to say that we have the best-in-class devices in that division too. And we've helped more than 1 million patients so far, something that's very important considering the opioid crisis. And we continue to grow. Not only do we have great products, but we also have a strong 400-man sales force that can get out into every corner of the country to get prescriptions from physicians that see patients in pain. All insurances generally cover our devices, and we expect long-term revenues to eventually hit or exceed 800 million.
And this is all powered by NextWave, right? Tell me a little bit about these products, and they really go down and pinpoint the pain relief, correct?
That's right. The NextWave device is not only what I consider our flagship, but it's also the product we currently generate the most revenue on. It's a very easy sell when you present this to physicians, and it's a device that primarily utilizes interferential current to provide electrotherapy, typically around the area of pain. It's very often prescribed by orthopedic surgeons. So after orthopedic surgery, a knee surgery, hip, or it could be elbow, shoulder, ankle, there's so many applications for it, where it helps not only relieve pain so that you can take less medication or none if that's the case, but also increase blood circulation so you heal so much faster, and therefore you have much much better outcomes, faster recovery, and obviously happier patients and physicians that continue to prescribe it repeatedly because of the results we see with the product. We have a number of other products too. Cervical traction, we have braces, we have cold therapy that also is used a lot after orthopedic surgery, and we have compression, and a number of other electrotherapy devices.
I would imagine that research and development is a big part of what you do at Zynex. Is that an accurate statement?
It certainly is in the monitoring division. We do have R&D efforts ongoing in the pain management division, but on another level, it's more maintenance, and occasionally we come out with new iteration of a product. So a product that's been derived from the next wave, the tens wave, just received FDA clearance. That's basically just broadening the offering we have in pain management.
You mentioned you started the company back 28 years ago, just from one room, and now where you are today, and you've been recognized numerous times as one of the top workplaces in the U.S. That must be exciting for someone who started with just the humble beginnings of a company to where you are today.
Yeah, the first many years, I think the first 4 years, there was only one person working at the company, and that was me, traveling all over the country, also being customer service and doing the first beginnings of developing the first products, dealing with the FDA, basically doing everything. And to now having 1,200 people, and as you mentioned, we have a great culture here. We have people that are very happy about working, and not just because of the purpose of helping patients in the pain, but also the culture that we have around here. As I normally say, culture is not something you develop by sending out motivational emails or putting posters on the wall. Culture is the people that walk in the door every morning. People don't change, so it's all about hiring the right people. And I think we've been very, very successful doing that, and been able to build a great company with great people.
And lastly, Thomas, you obviously 28 years ago had a vision of where you thought the company would get to. Looking to today now and forward, what's your vision? Has it changed, or is it still what you thought it would be some 28 years ago?
That's actually a good question. I think it's pretty much the same. I would say things never happen in a straight line, and obviously we have had ups and downs and very difficult times. But if you look at it in the big picture, I think it actually turned out a little better than what I thought it would be back 28 years ago. And we have a long runway, as I mentioned. 2 years out, we should hit 800 million in revenue in the pain management division, and there's a huge potential, obviously, in the monitoring division.
Absolutely. Thomas, thank you so much. Good to get caught up on where you're at, and congratulations on your success.
Yeah, thank you. Have a great day.
All right, there's Thomas Sandgaard. He's the CEO of Zynex.